Hello, Apple Valley High School Fab Lab students. Today what we're going to do is create a file that we can use for printing a heat press vinyl. And this is going to be a one color vinyl. So we're going to use Cut Studio to prepare the file to do that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and add a file. When you make heat press, the front of the shirt usually is about, the image size is about 10 to 11 inches is the max width. And then the height is usually about 10 or 11 inches too. So I'm gonna use that as my kind of guideline for size. So I'm gonna make an Apple Valley Eagle. So I downloaded this previously. So that's in my design file folder. And right now I have my grid set to 1-inch grids. So if I right click on this and go to image outline and then extract contour lines, that is going to be my cut contour. So I'm going to click OK. Now what I'm going to do is actually left click and drag off the cut contour. I don't need this image anymore. So I'm going to click on that and then hit the delete key. So that goes away. And that's my image that I can use for my shirt. I'm going to also add some text. I'm going to right click on this again and then go to properties. I'm going to keep the aspect ratio the same by checking that box. And right now this is about 11 inches wide, which is a little bit too big. I'm going to probably go down to like 10.5. for the width, and then hit the tab key, and then the height automatically adjusts. So it's about 7 inches tall, which is good because I want to put some text above it and below it. So I'm going to put Apple Valley on the top and then Eagles on the bottom. So I'm going to go to the text tool, and then I'm going to click and just type in Apple Valley. And then position that. I can also make it bigger. I'm going to hold the shift key to do that and grab the corner, and that will make the height and the length the same. And I'm going to make it about the same width as the image. And that looks pretty good. Might move it over a little bit. Just want to make sure it's centered. Now I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to put Eagles underneath. And I'm going to make that a little bit bigger too. And then hold the shift key and drag it bigger. That looks pretty good. Making sure it's centered. There are some tricks on how to center things, but you can just kind of eyeball it if you want. So now this is almost ready to print. If I did it like this to make a sticker, I could just leave it like it is, but I want to turn this into a heat press. And so when you use heat press vinyl, you're actually cutting the back side of the vinyl. So I have to mirror this. So I'm going to select everything. So I'm going to left click and select everything. Sometimes you don't get everything selected. So I'm going to hold the shift key and shift key and select. And then what I'm going to do is go up to Object and down to Mirror. And everything's flipped around. And you notice that that looks pretty good. So we're going to cut the back of this. So I can actually save this now. I'm just looking at where things are positioned. I'm going to move this a little bit to the left. That looks pretty good. Then I'm looking at the Eagles. And that looks pretty good. Move it a little bit this way. And then I'm going to hit save. So file, save. And I'm going to do Lee, last name, first initial, C. And then the class period I'm in. So 2, digital. And then the assignment is going to be heat press. So I'll just call it heat press. And then I'll save it. I'm saving it in. I'm going to save it to my desktop so that I can put it on a flash drive. And that's it. Then all we got to do is bring it over to the Final Cutter machine, and you can pick all kinds of different types of vinyl. So whatever we have, you can use for that. But what I'm going to do is have you select our class color shirts. So I've got shirts in black and white and yellow and brown. So depending on what grade you're in, you're going to have that color shirt. And then I'll have a set of vinyls that will look good on the type of color of shirt that you pick. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to put some heat press vinyl into the cutter. And what you notice is that it has a shiny side and then a dull side, and we're actually going to cut on the dull side. So this is going to be the real color of the vinyl when we heat press, but I have to cut on the back side. So we're going to put this into the machine, and I have a roller that this rolls on. And then once I get that set up, I have to have it over this sensor. This roller pin has to be on this white bar, and then if I move the head out of the way, we're going to have this pin, this roller pin, I'm going to actually put it to here so I can use the full width. So it's going to look something like that. This is going to go to there, and then I have a lever in the back here that I'm going to lock it in place. You can do that when it's turned on too. I'm going to hit the power button to turn it on. It loads very fast. I need to select the sheet. So if you look at here, you can actually arrow up and down. I could do the piece or an edge, but I'm going to just do the roll. So I'm going to hit the enter button to do that. And then it's going to go across and measure from roller to roller. So, and then it stores that, and we can grab that from the computer can grab that. So now what I got to do is change the force, because right now it's set for cutting sticker vinyl, and heat press vinyl is a little thicker. So I'm going to actually change this to about 120. So I hit the right arrow, and I'm going to arrow up to about 120, and then hit enter, and that should be good to go. I can hit menu, and it'll give me some other information, the cutting speed and what the force is that it's cutting at. So that's good to go. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to open up the software. We'll do a split screen with both that and the printer when it's cutting. Okay, so what I've done now is I've loaded the file into the computer, and we're going to open that file up in Cut Studio and then send it to the machine. So I'm gonna go File, Open. I'm gonna look for my file. I put it on the desktop so it's easy to find. I'm gonna open that up. And you notice that it put it way at the top, which is fine. I'm gonna move that to the bottom. So I'm gonna take everything, I'm gonna do Control A, and then I'm gonna just move it to the very bottom. So the default on this is it has the width as about 16, 17 inches, and then the length is like 62 inches, but you can change all those settings. So that looks pretty good. What I'm gonna do now is I'm going to get the cutting width. So I'm gonna go to File and Cutting Setup. And then I'm gonna go to Properties. This is the machine. We have the Roland GX-24 selected. So I'm gonna open up Properties. And the length is about 60 inches. I can change this to inches. And then I'm gonna get from machine. So it goes, the default is the entire width of the machine. But we didn't put that wide of vinyl in. So I'm gonna get the width. It's about 13 inches. I'm gonna click OK. And then click OK. And you notice that this changed because now this is the width of the vinyl. So the machine and the cutter, the computer and the vinyl cutter are now linked together. So the only thing I have to check is that this is mirrored, and it is. I did that when I was designing it. And this is ready to cut. So now I can either go up to here and click cutting or go file cutting. And I have the machine selected. I already did the width, so I can just click OK. And it'll cut it fairly fast. And you notice we're cutting the back side of the vinyl. And what I'll do when it's done is I'll pull it down low enough so that I can cut it off of the machine. If I had just a piece, I would just take the whole piece out. This slot is for where you put the utility knife to cut. And that's almost done. It's a really fast machine. The last thing it's gonna do is do the letters. It cuts the image out first. Now it's cutting the letters. Cutting the other letters, and then it'll be done. So what I'll do is I'll pause this again, take it out, and then we'll weed it. I'll show you how to weed that. And then we just need to line it up on our shirt and then put it in the heat press. And I turned the heat press on already. It takes about 20 minutes for the heat press to heat up. And I'll show you that next. So that's done. So now what I can do is release this, pull off this below that cut line, and then put my utility knife in and cut it off. And you can tell that it did cut, didn't go all the way through, so I think it's going to be pretty good for weeding.
So that's it for today. Have a great day.